Sunday, April the 4th, and 0 hour approaches for what promises to be another wet BOAC 1000 at Brands Hatch. Round 3 in the Manufacturers' Championship Series for Group 5 sports cars and Group 6 prototypes, organized by the BRSCC. We asked Vic Elford how he regarded the race.
All the big cars seem to be having problems at the moment with handling. For the first time, it looks like the 3-litre cars are going to clean up. Certainly, they have done so far in practice. So much for the wisdom of the FIA, who decided that as from next year, the limit would be cut to 3 litres to make the cars go slower. And they're already going quicker with 3 litres before they're even, before they've even got to be down to that size. As far as everything else goes for the meeting, it's always one of the nicest meeting at Brands Hatch, or at least it would be if the weather were a bit better. The organisation is always superb. There's never any problem about getting in the gate the first morning of practice. The flag marshalling, of course, is probably the best in the world. The general atmosphere of the meeting just couldn't be better.
The battle is joined with the 3-litre Group 6 cars, notably the Ferrari 312 and the Alfa T33-3. And when the flag falls into the lead goes Jackie Ickx in the Ferrari 312 from pole position. And then Elford in the Martini Porsche, unhappy on the wet track with intermediate tyres and having a big moment at South Bank. Rodriguez passes Stommelen and sets off after Ickx in the lead, with the rest of the field stringing out. The rain persists, and Rodriguez, at his best in these conditions, delights the large crowd with a superb display. We were not to know at Brands Hatch that we were watching this quiet little Mexican driver for the last time. With many cars not equipped with rain tires, drivers were having difficulty with some of the tight bends at Brands Hatch. Big Group 5 cars were proving to be a handful on this twisting circuit, and Rodriguez in the Gulf Porsche works hard to stay with Ickx in the prototype Ferrari. Porsche into the lead, followed by the two Alphas. Ferrari 312 is rebuilt in the pits, and Ickx rejoins the race 8 laps down and catches up with Rodriguez on the road. And together, these two work their way through the back markers. Dadamich in the Alpha passes teammate Stommelen to take third place. And the lights come on to penetrate the rain, and the first pit stop is only moments away. Rodriguez brings in the leading Gulf Porsche 917 to refuel. And the Gulf king-size refueler goes into action. The fuel goes in record time, and Rodriguez takes off. But the pipe remains attached, and pit manager David York has a tense moment. all is well, and Pedro rejoins in second place behind Cirfa. Now, Pescarolo comes in to refuel the Alpha. This pit favours the NASCAR churn, and the fuel goes in without a hitch. While co-driver Dadamich has a final word with Pescarolo. Now it's Ferrari's turn, and Ix brings in the 3-1-2. Regazzoni takes over. The fuel goes in. And he's away, now in eighth place, in spite of earlier troubles. This race is very demanding to the pit crew, who are glad of a few moments' respite between stops. Jackie Oliver anxiously awaits his turn with the Gulf Porsche from Rodriguez, while team leader John Wire records that he is overdue. The fuel blockage trouble which has dogged this car, finally retiring it at Dingle Dell. The Muller Ferrari 512 and the team Usdau Porsche 908 refueled. Those unsung heroes, the flag marshals, performing a magnificent job in appalling weather, are cheered as the rain eases a little and the track dries out. The Martini Porsche 917, driven by Marco and Van Lennep, is delayed at the pits with brake trouble. Now, the Gulf Pit prepares to bring in the leading Porsche 917 to refuel and change tyres. The team goes into action with their usual efficiency. But a tight wheel nut delays the car. How's this from a squirt off the pit? Now, Alpha leads the race. Siffert's troubles are not over, for he is further delayed by losing the spare wheel at Paddock. And Alphas then make it 1-2, with the Ferrari 3-1-2 now up in third place. With the end in sight, the leading Alpha, now being driven by Hazemans, blows up in a big way at Druids. Alpha number 54, now driven by Pescarolo, leads the race with the Ferrari in second place, the fastest car in the race, but unable to catch the leader. And Clem Greville-Smith flags the winning Alpha to score a historic victory for the team from Milan.